Imagine not eating for 7 entire days. No breakfast, no lunch, no dinner, just water and your willpower. Sounds extreme, right? Yet people all over the world are trying it, claiming it transforms not only their body, but their entire state of mind. But what actually happens when you push your body beyond the limits of everyday hunger? Science has some astonishing answers. In the first few hours, your body starts using up the glucose stored in your liver. This is your immediate energy supply, like the battery backup your body keeps just in case. But after that's gone, things start to shift. You begin burning fat for energy, and your brain starts receiving signals it's not used to handling. As the clock ticks toward the 24-hour mark, hunger hits hard. You might feel dizzy, tired, or even a little euphoric. Believe it or not, that's your body starting to adapt. Your system begins switching fuel sources, and something incredible is about to happen in your cells. Before we dive deeper into what your body does next, make sure you're subscribed. You won't want to miss what happens by day 3. The first 24 hours of fasting are like a biological revolution inside you. The digestive system shuts down temporarily, insulin levels drop, and your body releases glycogen to keep blood sugar stable. Meanwhile, hormones start firing messages to preserve muscle and burn fat instead. But here's the fascinating part. Even though you haven't eaten, your brain remains active. It starts producing more of a neurotransmitter called norepinephrine, the same one responsible for focus and alertness. That's why some people say they feel sharper while fasting. It's not just in their head, it's pure chemistry. However, this state comes with challenges. The body's stress response increases slightly, your mood can swing, and hydration becomes crucial. Miss your water intake and the fatigue can hit like a brick wall. But if you push through, your system starts unlocking its hidden survival code. By the end of day 1, your body has officially crossed a biological line, one that evolution designed for survival thousands of years ago. And this is just the beginning. Here's where things get strange. By the second day, hunger starts to fade. You'd expect to be starving, but instead, a calm focus begins to set in. That's your brain switching gears. Ketone bodies, produced by your liver, become your new fuel, and they do something fascinating to your mind. Ketones can cross the blood-brain barrier and feed your neurons directly, keeping your brain sharp even when your stomach is empty. Ancient humans relied on this state for survival during food shortages. It's a mechanism that kept us alert enough to hunt even when we hadn't eaten for days. But this shift also brings an emotional twist. Some people report feeling spiritually clear or unusually peaceful. Scientists believe this is linked to changes in serotonin and dopamine regulation, your body's way of rewarding endurance. It's a natural mental high. Still, your body is working hard behind the scenes. Muscles conserve protein, metabolism slows slightly, and your system prepares for long-term adaptation. You've officially entered the deeper stages of fasting, and your cells are about to start something extraordinary. Around the 48-hour mark, your body activates a process that's nothing short of biological magic, autophagy. This is when your cells start breaking down and recycling old, damaged components. Think of it as your body's built-in detox system. No juice cleanse is required. Japanese scientist Yoshinori Osumi won the Nobel Prize in 2016 for discovering this process. Autophagy literally means self-eating, but in a good way. Your body starts digesting waste material, rogue proteins, and malfunctioning mitochondria, turning them into fuel for survival.
It's one of the reasons why fasting has been linked to longevity and reduced risk of diseases like Alzheimer's, diabetes, and even cancer. Your body is rebooting at the cellular level. Every hour you stay in this state, you're giving your system a deep internal cleanse. But the benefits come with responsibility. Overdue fasting, and your body might begin cannibalizing muscle instead of waste. The key lies in balance and understanding how long you can safely sustain it. By the third day, your metabolism makes a dramatic shift. Your body recognizes the absence of food as a serious situation and begins conserving energy. Heart rate slightly lowers, core temperature may drop, and your system becomes astonishingly efficient. Now, FAC is the main fuel source. The liver is in full production mode, generating ketones to feed your brain. Your digestive organs rest while the body reroutes energy toward maintenance and repair. It's like shutting down unnecessary systems to keep the essential ones alive. Interestingly, some studies suggest that in this state, the body becomes more resilient to stress and inflammation. White blood cells begin regenerating, and immune function may actually improve. Your body, in a sense, is learning to heal itself. Still, fasting for this long isn't for everyone. The lack of nutrients can stress the system, especially if hydration or electrolytes aren't maintained. But the transformation, both physical and mental, has only just begun. By the third day, something incredible happens. Your body starts reinventing itself from the inside out. The energy once used for digesting food is now redirected toward repairing tissues, healing inflammation, and regenerating cells. The fatigue that marked your first days begins to fade, replaced by an odd sense of clarity and alertness. It's as if your body finally understands the new rhythm and starts embracing it. Deep within your bloodstream, insulin levels are now significantly lower, which allows fat to break down at a faster rate. The liver continues producing ketones, which now account for most of your brain's energy supply. This shift not only fuels mental sharpness, but also protects neurons from oxidative stress. Scientists believe this is one of the evolutionary reasons humans survived long periods without food. Fasting literally sharpened our senses. However, day three isn't all about euphoria. Some people may experience dizziness, mild headaches, or difficulty sleeping. This is the body's way of adapting, recalibrating hormones and neurotransmitters to stabilize energy and mood. Hydration and electrolytes become crucial at this stage. Without them, even the strongest willpower can falter. By the end of this day, your system is functioning at peak efficiency. It's no longer panicking about food. It's optimizing itself for survival. What once felt like deprivation now starts to feel like evolution in real time. By day four, most people expect exhaustion, yet many report the exact opposite, a strange surge of energy that seems to come from nowhere. The secret lies in ketones, the molecules your liver produces from fat. They are the body's emergency fuel source, but they come with a surprising side effect, mental clarity. Ketones provide a steadier energy flow than glucose, so instead of crashes and cravings, you experience a calm, sustained alertness. Inside your cells, mitochondria, the tiny power plants, become more efficient at burning fat. This metabolic shift is what many biohackers call metabolic freedom. Your body no longer depends on constant meals to stay functional. It can create energy anytime from its own reserves. For many, this is a liberating realization. Yet, the sudden boost can be misleading. Without proper mineral intake, the body risks electrolyte imbalances, leading to fatigue or even heart palpitations. That's why even during fasting, smart hydration is non-negotiable. Salt, magnesium, and potassium play a quiet but vital role in keeping this delicate system in balance.
And so, on this fourth day, your body becomes an energy alchemist, transforming stored fat into life force. You are, in essence, burning away not just physical reserves, but everything unnecessary for survival. It's biological minimalism at its finest. Now comes one of the most fascinating parts of extended fasting: mental focus. As glucose levels drop and ketones dominate, your brain's chemistry changes. Studies have shown that fasting boosts the production of brain-derived neurotrophic factor, or BDNF, a protein that supports learning, memory, and the growth of new neural connections. It's like fertilizer for your mind. People often describe this state as a mental flow, where ideas come easily, distractions fade, and tasks seem clearer. This isn't placebo. It's evolutionary. Early humans needed sharp mental faculties to find food while hungry. Your brain, in fasting mode, is returning to that primal alertness. It's working harder, faster, and smarter. There's also a psychological component. With your digestive system quiet and your energy balanced, your mind becomes more aware of subtle sensations, thoughts, emotions, focus. Many report feeling more mindful, even spiritual. Some monks and ancient cultures practiced fasting precisely for this heightened state of consciousness. Still, the challenge remains, staying disciplined when your instincts scream to eat. This stage of fasting tests not only biology, but also willpower. If you can maintain calm through the noise of hunger, you start discovering what your mind is truly capable of. Every great transformation has a shadow side, and fasting for 7 days is no exception. While the body adapts in remarkable ways, pushing it too far can lead to dangerous consequences. When nutrient stores run low, your body might begin breaking down muscle for protein, especially if hydration and minerals aren't maintained. This process can weaken the heart and impair organ function over time. Your electrolytes, sodium, potassium, and magnesium, are essential for keeping your heartbeat stable. Without them, the balance between electrical signals in the heart and brain can falter. That's why medical supervision is recommended for fasts longer than 72 hours. Even the most disciplined individuals can experience sudden dizziness, fatigue, or confusion. Another hidden risk is something called refeeding syndrome. After a long fast, eating too much too quickly can shock the body, leading to dangerous shifts in fluid and electrolyte levels. In extreme cases, it can be fatal. That's why ending a fast properly is just as important as beginning one carefully. So yes, fasting can transform you, but it's not a challenge to take lightly. The line between healing and harm is thin, and knowing how to respect that line is what separates a life-enhancing experience from a dangerous mistake. You've reached day 7. The summit of fasting. At this point, your body is a masterpiece of adaptation. Fat burning efficiency is at its highest, inflammation markers are at their lowest, and autophagy is still running strong, cleaning every cell with surgical precision. You've officially entered a biological state few people ever experience. But beyond the science, something deeper happens. Many fasters describe day 7 as a profound moment of clarity, an emotional reset. The noise of cravings, stress, and routine quiets down, replaced by a sense of peace and gratitude. Your mind becomes lighter, your senses sharper, and your awareness more vivid. It's as if the body and mind finally align in perfect silence. Inside, stem cells begin to regenerate, repairing tissues and strengthening your immune system. White blood cell production rises, and your gut prepares for new beginnings. You're not just fasting, you're renewing yourself from the inside out. Still, this is the limit. Beyond 7 days, risks start outweighing benefits unless guided by medical professionals. You've climbed the mountain, witnessed what the body is capable of, and now it's time to descend carefully, because the next step is as critical as the journey itself. After 7 days without food, the moment you finally eat feels sacred. But here's the twist. This is the most delicate stage of the entire process. Your digestive system has been asleep for a week. Your enzymes are low, and your gut lining is unusually sensitive. That first bite, if too heavy, can shock the body. This reaction is known as refeeding syndrome, and it's one of the most dangerous mistakes long-term fasters can make. When food suddenly floods back into the system, insulin spikes and electrolytes rush into cells too quickly. This can lead to severe imbalances in potassium, magnesium, and phosphorus, all vital for keeping your heart beating. That's why breaking a fast should always begin gently. Small portions, easily digestible foods, and lots of fluids. Think of it as teaching your body to eat again, step by step. At this stage, digestion restarts like a long dormant engine. The gut microbiome, the trillions of bacteria inside you, begins to reawaken. The way you refeed can shape your health for weeks afterward, influencing metabolism, inflammation, and even mood stability. It's not just about eating again, it's about resetting your entire system. In essence, the end of fasting is not the end of transformation. It's the rebirth phase, the part where your body takes everything it's learned from deprivation and turns it into lasting renewal. Modern research has taken fasting from ancient ritual to cutting-edge science. Studies from Harvard, Stanford, and the University of Southern California have shown that prolonged fasting triggers cellular regeneration, reduces oxidative stress, and boosts longevity markers. It's not pseudoscience, it's biology working at its most primal level. One of the most fascinating discoveries is that fasting activates genes responsible for longevity, the same ones triggered by calorie restriction, known to extend lifespan in animals. Researchers also found that periodic fasting can reduce the risk of metabolic diseases, improve insulin sensitivity, and even help to regenerate the immune system after chemotherapy. In short, fasting turns on a survival program coded deep within our DNA. But science is also clear on one thing: fasting isn't for everyone. Those with chronic conditions, eating disorders, or metabolic imbalances should never attempt it without medical guidance. What works as medicine for one body can become poison for another. Balance and understanding are key. Fasting is not just skipping meals, it's reconnecting with an ancient biological rhythm that modern life has silenced. It's a reminder that your body still remembers how to survive, heal, and renew itself, if only you give it the chance. If you found this fascinating, you might want to see what happens when you fast for just 24 hours. The results will surprise you. So after all the science, struggle, and transformation, is it worth it? The truth is, fasting for 7 days is less about weight loss or quick detoxes and more about discovery. It's a journey into the deepest layers of what your body and mind can endure. You learn how adaptable, intelligent, and resilient your biology truly is. It's not starvation, it's controlled renewal. Those who've completed a week-long fast often describe not just physical change, but perspective. Food becomes more meaningful. Gratitude deepens. The noise of constant consumption fades, replaced by appreciation for simplicity. It's as if the body, in silence, teaches the mind a forgotten truth. We need far less than we think to thrive. But fasting this long is not something to romanticize. It requires preparation, discipline, and awareness. Without those, the risks can outweigh the rewards. The goal isn't to push your body to extremes, it's to listen to it in a way most people never do. That's where the real power of fasting lies. And as your body returns to normal eating, remember this: you've just witnessed the miracle of human adaptation. A week without food didn't weaken you, it revealed how much strength you already had. If this deep dive opened your eyes, make sure to subscribe, like, and share this video with someone curious about what the body is truly capable of. You won't want to miss the next exploration into the hidden science behind everyday habits.